Stop Blues. For the first time available ever, an essential collection of songs by Lisa. Featuring the autobiographical ballad, Crazy and Lazy.
Cause I'm so crazy, I'm so lazy, I'm so crazy.
The spellbinding classic, Boring and Snoring.
Charlie's lying down on the grass. David's snoring off his ass.
Forever and a Dave, a tribute to her pipe and soulmate David.
I need you to keep me strong. Whoa.
And many, many more. Order your copy now for only a cup of tea and some fags, plus postage and packaging.
Have you always been musical?
Yeah, I love it.
You're a real lyricist, Lisa.
I love singing.
Do you think maybe you could be a blues singer?
Not a possible career for you?
There was one lady there who'd buy the album. That's one
song.
That's great.
Can't be bad. Thanks.
There's two. We got two songs. We're working on one. I'm sure your mum and your auntie will get some.
Yeah.
We sold five copies, everybody. How about that? It's a beautiful thing.
Thank you.
You and the housemates commented that the people that you seem to get close to throughout the series kind of got booted out. Sophia, Chris, Shree, Carly B, all of a sudden they get near you and then the next thing they were out the door. Do you think there's any truth in that?
Well, Sophie's still in there. Sophie will probably be the winner.
You think she's going to win, do you?
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. Very popular lady.
No truth in it.
Not at all. Lisa, you've been a tremendous housemate. Better than that. Here are your BBLB highlights, darling.
Right, great.
It's Lisa!
I'm so excited now.
Your role is extremely important and is not to be taken lightly.
Cut. She's like my mum in the house.
You're one hell of a woman and that's it.
Yeah!
Never forget your lease.
Bye, babe.
She's being herself.
Whoa!
I don't think she's done anything for the cameras.
Big brother is going crazy in the house.
Lisa's up for eviction.
I still feel like I'm a winner. From coming through all that way and getting through to here, I think my friends and family will be really proud of me and I'm quite proud of myself.
Lovely.
Love you loads, Liz.
On your bike then, Lisa.
I love you.
Lisa, everybody, Lisa!
Thank you.
Coming up, Kieran Bracken and Lisa will be showing off their acting skills, and so will I, my darlings. There you go. Was that thespian enough for you? We'll see you in three.
Charlie, you got evicted due to unacceptable behaviour.
What?
Yeah. It's in the rules book.
It's really warm.
Charlie, my...
Welcome back to BBLB. It's day 91. The time is 6:17. In 2 days' time, we will have the winner of Big Brother 2009, everybody. And my next guest is an expert in winning. He won the Rugby World Cup for England and he was crowned the winner of Dancing on Ice. It's Kieran Bracken. And I know which medal takes pride of place in Kieran's house, and it's the dancing one. That's for sure, the skating one, sorry.
Did
the right person go, Kieran, last night?
Well, she's in the audience, but I have to say, I thought so. Mainly because she didn't like anyone who I liked watching. I mean, Halfoot was so funny, and they were just at each other all the time. She was like the matriarch, wasn't she, of the house?
Of course she was. I noticed she hasn't taken the nicotine patch off. I noticed that. Yeah. She's having a great old time over there.
Yeah.
How do you think Lisa's exit is going to change the dynamic in the group?
Well, I think the group are now, because it was, the day she left, there was two groups, wasn't it? Her and David, and the rest of them. It's always been her with a few people and the rest of them. Now I think they're all going to bond, all be very happy. So it's going to be really boring.
Harmonious.
Let's bring Halfwit back in there. What do you reckon?
Do
you know what I mean?
You're a massive Halfwit fan. Has it been difficult for you to watch the show without him in it?
It has really. And I think what happens is the people we like to watch, the sort of extravagant ones, the weird ones, the socially inept ones, are the ones you want to watch and you go, I can't believe he or she's just done that. And those are all starting to go. And at the end, we've got people who, you know, someone's going to win it, like Sophie, who's been like...
They really like Sophie
but
tonight.
I know, people really, but it's like... Sophie won, brilliant. Like Rachel last year. You know, that's why I want Seabass.
She was a great winner. What are you talking about?
Seabass. I want Seabass to win.
Now, you're a big, big brother fan, right? You've been watching it all
been
summer.
Watching
it's
going
to be off
also.
Now. What are you going to do in the dark winter nights till we get to celebrate?
I just don't know. I mean, I think this has been the best one.
I think you're probably right.
And I have to say, and I'm going to miss you. I don't watch you in the evenings. I watch you in the mornings with my little kids. And they
Kieran's
say, Daddy, what are we watching? Said, you've got to watch George. You've got to watch George. He knows what's happening.
There's a smart dad there.
You should do this full time. Very good.
That's a shrewd dad. Thank you very much, sir. Now, what's been your favourite moment of the series?
I've really enjoyed Noreen, the boys sort of congregating around her and her sort of playing each other off. And then Marcus...
It was good to watch, though, wasn't
Marcus
it?
Thinks he's got a slight chance in there, which he just doesn't. And then Seabass jumps in and then he's like, oh, no. And then the boyfriend
That was some TV gold. You're right.
It was great.
What about the acting talent in the house? We saw Sophie last night trying to recreate
What about
that?
Those accents? How that bad was she? She was trying to do Noreen. And the Irish accent, I mean, it turned into a Liverpool stroke Welsh accent, you know.
It was absolutely. And I love that she had her card down there, she's trying to read it and
that's
look
right,
around
absolutely,
and doing this terrible
yeah.
Scouse accent that actually should have been Irish. It was really, really bad.
Have you been feeding her, though? The poor thing. She, you know, I don't know what she's... I mean, there's supposed to be rations. And
she's been feeding herself.
She's been doing it herself.
Can you do a more convincing Noreen?
Noreen, look, I just want to be friends in the house, OK? I just want to be friends and keep friends. Well, could you give a little kiss there, you know?
Yeah, I think that was pretty good, don't you?
I don't know.
And now, obviously, with all the dancing and ice that you do, you're used to wearing silly Lycra outfits.
I do like my Lycra.
Looking real nice. A little bit yellow there. I wanted to see what you thought of Siavash's get-up. He's looking...
Now, that could easily have been in his wardrobe because he wears the most outrageous clothes, so I think he does
quite
well in that.
Could have brought that
Can
in
you
with
imagine him on Dancing in Ice? Get him on it like that.
Well,
fantastic.
You never know, mate.
You never know. No, absolutely.
Who do you want to win?
I want Seabass to win.
Really?
I'd like him to win. I know. He's just been fun the whole time. I like Charlie. I have to say I like Charlie. He's been a little bit fun. Paul Gascoigne's long-lost son, maybe. I don't know. I think Sophie's going to win. You know, my winner was always Halfwit.
All right, mate. Well, listen, we'll have to wait and see what happens.
Yeah.
Kieran Brackett, everybody. Now, there are only 2 days left of Big Brother 2009, everybody. I know. But who wins? You decide. Yeah! Who said this was a pantomime? Here are the numbers to call.
Who wins Big Brother 2009? You decide. Call 09016 1616. For Charlie to win at 04. For David to win at 18. For Rodrigo to win at 11. For Siavash to win at 13. For Sophie to win at 15. Calls cost 35p from a BT landline. Other networks may vary. Mobiles will cost considerably more. Details and terms at channel4.com/Big Brother. Voting closes in Friday's live final.
Now, we saw the acting skills in the house last night, so we thought we'd try to top their performances with another classic scene that we like to call Chicken Nugget Gate. You remember that, don't you? Here we have the incredible Lisa playing Marcus. You took to the role so brilliantly in the house when you were doing that recreation the other night. I'll be taking the role of B, everybody. I'm so sad. And Kieran here... Oh, I'm not actually sad at all, I'm just playing it. And Kieran is going to take Lisa's part, all right?
A cup of tea.
And we've got our cameraman. He's a professional cameraman and he brought his own camera in from home just to film this, all right? So have we got the clapperboard? Can we do that? Action!
If we get 3 each, then out are people getting 4 and 5. And that, what the... We knew that when we brought them, there were 24.
So how many was there for each?
3. So why are people eating 4 and 5? This is what gets up my nose. People see things and it makes a feeding frenzy and everyone else just piles in. No, you know what you got.
Well, you're amazing, Mark. Sorry. If I had... I've had four, and I was under the impression it was all right to have four. Sophie and Rodrigo had four, and they're always having some the other day. And then Charlie had five the other night, and I'm cooking them, but I'm not actually going to eat any of them. So if anyone who actually wants chicken nuggets, do you want to take over cooking the chicken nuggets? I'm not having any.
People usually cook if they're not eating anyway, boy.
Oh, you didn't cook your dinner?
Well, please, now you've started.
All right. That's it, guys. If you've done any reconstruction, send them in to us. I'm a big thank you to all my guests. I'll be back here at 6 o'clock tomorrow on Info. And don't forget to watch the main show tonight at 9 on Channel 4. Take care.